My name is Laurie Eggert. I'm an associate professor of biological sciences at the University of Missouri. For many years, my research team and I have used genetic tools to learn more about elephants and other elusive or dangerous animals around the world. Many of the techniques my team and I have developed are focused on elephant populations in Africa and in Asia. Our goal is to use these techniques to collect and analyze information that will help us learn about the ecology of these species and provide data that will help wildlife managers make better decisions about endangered animals and the habitats they occupy. A 2006 study that my lab team and I conducted in collaboration with the Wildlife Conservation Society using funding from the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service shows how this works. The construction of a hydropower dam on the Namtoon River was about to severely restrict the available habitat for the Asian elephants of the Nakai Plateau in Laos. It was crucial that we have a better understanding of the size, health, and genetic diversity of the elephant herd to allow the government of Laos to make sound decisions about managing the population during and after dam construction. We began the project with a dung count. This involved breaking the habitat into 16 geographical blocks ranging from 2 to 8 square kilometers. Members of our field research team visited each block once a month, noting the number and locations of the dung piles they encountered. Since the size of elephants corresponds directly with their age and bigger elephants leave larger dung, we measured the circumferences of boli. This is the name we use to describe an individual piece of dung that we found in each pile. We also collected samples for genetic testing in the lab. We learned from the dung count that only 5 of the 16 blocks showed evidence of recent elephant activity. Through boli measurements, we were able to determine that the population consisted of 40 adults, 31 sub or young adults, 21 juveniles, and 10 elephants of an age we couldn't determine because we didn't have bolus circumference measurements. Our samples for genetic testing, meanwhile, were preserved in a buffer and stored at room temperature until they could be brought to the lab. Once they reached Colombia, we extracted DNA from each one and genotyped it, which involves creating a genetic profile for the elephant that left the dung. Since each individual has a unique genotype, we were able to analyze our results to determine the number of individuals we encountered or captured, as well as the number of times we encountered them again, or recaptured them. From the DNA analysis, we learned that we had collected samples from 102 individuals and that this group contained 79 females and 29 males. Analysis of the capture and recapture history of those individuals suggested that there were approximately 132 elephants in the whole population. There was a high level of genetic diversity in this group, with the highest diversity in blocks 9 and 10, which were in the center. We also determined that females and young appeared to represent traditional family groups, and that males tended not to be related to the female groups, which suggests that they may move into area from more than one location, mixing populations to avoid inbreeding between close relatives. So when we combine the data, what does all this mean? We were able to report that this population is genetically robust and not in immediate danger of heavy inbreeding, that it's important to conserve because it is perhaps the largest population of Asian elephants in Laos, that it's likely to be part of a larger metapopulation since the genetic diversity level is relatively high and the social structure is similar to that of larger populations elsewhere, and that it's likely that these elephants will move as relatively large family groups in search of new habitat if their current habitat is lost. The dam was built and began operating in March 2010, and studies are underway to understand its actual effects on the elephants and other wildlife species. In this, and in most of the work that we do, the goal is not to make specific recommendations about the management of this population. Our job was simply to provide a foundation of data on which decisions can be made by others. In this way, we hope to make a difference not only for the reclusive or dangerous animals living in remote locations like Laos, but also for animals residing closer to home, such as Missouri's black bears and river otters.